All right, everybody, Geoff Carter, eh? I never guess who I'm with. It's only the one and only.
Dee Dee, back in the city of my birth. We're in Chester.
Chester? Wow. So you was born here in the city of Chester many, many moons ago.
Many, many moons ago, yeah. I can't remember much about it.
Can you imagine him? Little Dee Dee Lewis with a nappy on, just crawling round the floor, round the streets of Chester. Where did you end up living then?
Warrington in the end.
In the end, he ended up in Warrington with me. Anyway, he said to me, come on, let's go Chester and have a look round. Why, it's a lovely day because it's winter soon, and it is a lovely day, it's warming up. I'm a bit cold at the moment. Dee Dee's got his big jumper on.
Yep, jumper's on, ready.
It's called knowledge, but I bet he takes it off later. We're going to have a walk round the walls. We're going to go round the shops, and what's that pub? We're going in one of them pubs, up in the Rose it's called, isn't it?
Yeah, I can't remember the name.
Right, we're going to go round a few pubs in the marketplace, maybe have a look down at the river, etc. So, come on.
Keep smiling.
Let's go. Right, Dee Dee, where are we heading off to first?
Well, head down City Road, eh?
City Road, right, okay. This is Queen's Hotel and City Road. I tell you something, there's too much traffic round here, too much noise. We're going down City Road now, and then this takes us into the heart of Chester and within the Chester walls. And when we get there, I've got some top info for you, Dave.
Right.
I've been studying it, finding out all about the oldie-worldie times of Chester. Right, we're just on the outskirts now of the city walls. I'll just show you here. A few little boozers I used to go in here years ago. And just down here now, we've got to go underneath the road. Right, just down and under here now, Dave. Under the main road. And then we'll go over to the right. All right.
Yep.
Yep. Just round here now. Whey. Round we go. Dee Dee, coming up now is called Eastgate, and it's only one archway now, but I believe in the olden days it was like a trader's route. And it was two archways,
was it?
Yep. And here now you've got the Eastgate clock. I'll just show you that now. We'll do your close-up in a minute. And do you know what, Dee Dee?
What?
That is the second most photographed clock in England.
Is it?
What's number one?
Big Ben.
Big Ben is correct. Armando, you have just got yourself a free pint. So there we go, we're at Eastgate, and look how beautiful all these buildings are. All absolutely fantastic. Wow. And there it is, Eastgate clock. Wonderful. Right, we're going up there, Dave. Let's go. Right, Dee Dee, do you fancy walking around the full wall?
Yeah, that's a good idea. I'd like to go down to the river as well.
Yep, okay. So, we're now going to go right round, anti-clockwise, and then we'll end up going past the racecourse.
Right.
That's good there, Chester Racecourse. And then we're going to go down to the boom shakalaka, and we're going to go, woo, Arsenal. We're going to go, what again? We're going to go right round, and then obviously we'll end up in some establishments, as you should call them, Dave.
For refreshment.
For some nice refreshments after this very long walk. And it's a pleasant day, isn't it?
Yep.
Fantastic. So we're going to go down here now, look. Follow that woman there. There you go.
Yeah, Geoff, Chester Cathedral. And it's a cathedral, not a church. That's why Chester's a city.
Very nice, Dave. Lovely that, isn't it? And here now is the Nature Gardens Cafe Bar and Grill. And coming up on this big field now, this is where they fly all the kestrels and eagles and the big owls in this falconry centre. And you can pay to have a falcon on your arm. So that's good, isn't it? But there's no falcons flying today, but there you are, just there for you on that beautiful big field. And this, Dave, is King Charles Tower. And this is where they had a lookout to stop all invaders. There you go. Because people always try to invade the city of Chester, and this was a meeting place and also where they looked out for oncoming invaders. And now we're going up here over one of the main roads, and in the distance you can now see North Wales. Are you enjoying it, Dave?
Yep, nice and steady, relaxing, peaceful.
It's a good walk, isn't it?
Yeah, sound.
Yeah, loving it. We're now coming up to the all-girls school, like the St. Trinians. And then once you get past there, we're going to come to the Chester Racecourse. So it's just down here. Right, Dee Dee, I'm going to tell you some info.
Come on, let's have it.
Right here now, we're at the start of Chester Racecourse, right?
Yep.
And there used to be a bar here. And I turned up to watch one of the races with all my mates.
What?
I'll show you in a minute. And I only had a jacket and a shirt on. And the bloke said, hang on a minute, you've got to have a tie to get in there tonight. Just down there it was, look. So he said to me, yeah, I'll sell you one for a fiver. So I bought a tie off him for £5.
Yep.
And I went, what's the score with these? He went, I go, every second-hand shop in Chester, I buy all the ties for 50p and I sell them for a fiver and made a fortune every week. And that was just down there, the start of the race course. You're loving it, Dave?
Yeah, it's soundless, nice.
Fantastic.
The sun's out and everything.
Yep, you'll have that jumper off soon, I told you.
No, I like it warm.
Right, we've now just crossed the main road and we're on the wall still, and we're heading now towards the River Dee. So we've come off the wall now and down, following the lower wall, which is bringing us at the side of the River Dee Dee. Woohoo! The River Dee Dee? Yeah. I wonder whether that's why, because you was born here, weren't you?
Yeah, I don't think they've named the river after me though.
Don't know, Dave. Anyway, you what?
I think it was here first.
Maybe. Only having a laugh, folks. Now we've come to the main bridge here now on the River Dee. And in the olden days, this was the only route through from Wales into England via Chester. And here it is, still standing, all made out of sandstone. Right, we've come off the River Dee now because we're going to go down the bottom end, but Dee Dee said he don't want to drink yet. So we're up on the main road again, and he wants to have a look at the amphitheatre. So here he is on his little day out, D.D. Lewis, at the amphitheatre in Chester. That's it, the Roman amphitheatre. Right then, mate, here's a factoid for you.
Go on, give it to me.
In the olden days in Chester, they used to have a curfew.
Right.
Now, I don't know what time the curfew was at night, but if you was from Wales, you had to leave the walls of Chester before the curfew came in. If they caught you, you could go to jail as a spy for many years, and in some cases, they killed you.
Wow.
How about that then? There's a fact you didn't know about Chester, and if you don't believe me, check it out. Spies. You'd never believe that, would you, mate?
No, not spies.
Because when you look at this amphitheatre behind us now, look, this is where all the Romans used to perform. And do you know Chester didn't just have Romans?
What else did it have?
It had Saxons, Normans, and I didn't believe this when I read it.
What?
Vikings.
Vikings as well.
And what did they used to come and do?
Conquer, rape and pillage.
Conquer. Yes, it is. It's conquer season. Oh, you didn't mean that type of conquer.
No.
Conquering, pillaging and raping. Anyway, it's got loads of history, this, but I think the Romans actually built most of it. I'm not sure. If you know better, leave it in the comments below, because we'd like to read it, wouldn't we?
Yep, definitely.
So there we are now. We're going to head now into Chester City Centre via the wall again now, because I know you can get up, because I was here the other week, and you can get up, and I'll give you some more interesting factoids.
You're full of it today, aren't you?
Oh, I'm full of it. All right. Okay, let's carry on. There's a tethering stone, and on the drawing here, you can see it had a chain where they actually chained somebody up there. And what did they bring through there? Could it have been lions? Friends, Romans and countrymen. Look at that. Absolutely fantastic. I'll tell you something though, I wouldn't have liked being here tied up to that stone there if they were coming and hitting you with big sticks or swords or bringing lions out. I don't know. It's an amphitheatre and it was for entertainment. So what went on here? I don't know. I'll have to read up on it. But looking at the big space around me now and everybody like that and then fighting with swords and shields and spears and then maces. Whoa, frightening stuff. Anyway. DD's had enough. He's up there. I think he wants to go to the pub. All right, DD! And if you're wondering what all these big timbers are for, these were the foundations for the seating area. And taking advantage of the stone wall is the one and only DD Lewis.
We're at the Roman Gardens now, according to this sign. Come on, let's go and have a look, and you can tell me what facts you've learnt about that.
Right, Dave, come on then, let's show you.
All right, sure.
Got a nice big mosaic here, all done nicely. And then, what you're going to see here now in these gardens, just below the Chester wall, is loads of remnants of big columns. Can you see? Going all the way down the park here now. Now then, these ain't from here.
Where are they from then?
They're from all over Chester, what they found, and they decided to put them all in one place rather than leave them scattered so people could come and have a little look at them.
Right.
So let's just have a little walk through, Dave, because it's interesting down here. And basically all these are from all over Chester. And this bit here, Dave, is part of the Roman baths, where the Romans on the day off used to come and bathe and relax. Right, let's get back up on the wall, Dave. Via Park Street, up back onto the wall. Down here now, some small cottages, and look how small the doorways are. Now then, the inscription on this building says, "The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life, And do you know why that was on there, Dee Dee?
No, you'll have to tell me.
It was because when they were actually building this building, when they were digging down for the foundations, they found a Roman coin. And the inscription on the coin said, "The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life." So they thought it was fitting to put it on the building, well, which is now a dentist. Have that? Right, after that little tour then, we've decided to go back down onto street level, because in about another 100 yards, we're back to the Eastgate clock, and we've already done the full thing then. So we're just going to go now, and Dee Dee's leading the way. We're going to have a few pints of Chester beer. How about that then? Oh, can't wait.
So come on, what more facts have we got?
Well, we've got another factoid here, Dave, from many years ago when I was Northwest champion at skateboarding. And see this place here? It was called Ruin Orchard, right? It's a Thailand restaurant now, but it used to be called the Great American Disaster.
Yes.
Do you remember it?
I remember it years ago.
And it was an American diner, had all disasters in newspapers all over the walls, and your food was served on a wooden plate with chips and a big American burger. And you had this thing called cucumber relish. It was absolutely fantastic.
I vaguely remember it.
Honestly, we used to go skateboarding in at the back of the race course, I'll forget the name of it right now, but we went up there and then we'd come down here at night and then we'd have some food in here. It was absolutely fantastic. Yeah. Blakenpoint. You see, my brain matter, if I just train my mind, it'll happen. And look at these here beautiful chilies. Well, they're hot. But we're not having Thailand food yet. We may have a little surprise for Dee Dee Lewis later.
You've not got a Ruin Thai anywhere, have
you? No, we haven't. Don't worry. We're going down here now to a very old-fashioned boozer. And inside it, David, listen to me.
Listening.
David, don't be looking at them girls in the shop.
Listening.
Right. Down here now, it's got a knight in shining armour inside the pub.
Wow.
And it serves beer. So come on, let me buy you a pint.
Okay.
Beep, beep. Right, so here we are, Dave. The old King's Head, built in 1622, but the beer's a bit newer, so come on, let's go inside and have a pint. Well, there we go, ye old King's Head, built in 1622. It was nice in there, Dave, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Yeah, nice ambient atmosphere.
Yeah, where are you taking me now?
Let's go to the Rose, down to the roller shops called the Rose. We're
right.
Going down there.
Yeah, we're going up there now, or down there. We're going up, Dave said down, but we're going up. And that's because we've had ups and downs, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, we're going up there now. Apparently it's on the second level, that's why it's called the Rose. We can't remember the name of the boozer, but we'll let you know when we get there. Oh. So as you can see now, there's two rows of shops, ground level and the first level. And there's not many of these towns around the country that have split level shopping. And what it enabled people to do is get twice as many shops in the same area. And absolutely fantastic. Look how beautiful them old buildings are, look. Wow.
Here you go, Geoff. It's here. The old boot in. We'll go and have a look at that, shall we?
Yep, it's just up there on the second row. Just up here. Right, up these steep steps onto the second row. You've been in before, Dave?
Yes.
Right, there. Big sign. The boot in. Let's have it.
Quite enjoy the Sam Smiths in this pub. It's well worth a visit.
Cider Reserve, fantastic.
Quarterly, half yearly, or yearly.
Ooh, cheers. What do you think, Dave?
Fantastic. They don't make them like this anymore, do they?
No. Right, on to the next boozer. More black and white buildings. And now we're making our way to the marketplace.
Chiang Noi, take me home, I can't get on it.
Chiang Noi, baby elephant in Thai. Look at that. You ready for another beer, Dave?
Okay, well, didn't know it.
Right, Dave, let's try the Shropshire Arms Craft Union Freehouse.
Okay, we'll give it a whirl.
Right, Dave, what are you getting?
I'm having a farmer's blonde.
Yeah, get me a Carling, mate.
Okay.
Cheers. Wow, what a lovely bar. Fantastic. Right, Dave, here we are in the market entrance. What do you fancy, food or drink?
Food, definitely food.
What type of food?
I think we'll try Thai food.
Is it a Thai place, isn't it?
I believe so, yes.
Fantastic.
Come on, let's have a look. I don't know where it is. We'll have a look now.
Let's have a wander around, yeah? All right, Dave?
Yep, Sam.
Woohoo! Wow, look at this lot, Dave. Look at that for a cactus. Growers of hardy plants direct to the public. Whoa. Just looking around here now. Brilliant. Where's the Thai shop, mate?
We'll have to carry on looking round. Not sure. Let's go over there.
I can't find this place. Do you know where it is?
It's there, look, just in the corner. You can see it.
Oh, right, okay. Thai by Thai. Yeah, look. Thai by Thai. Fantastic find, Dave. Well done, mate. What are you having?
I'm having my normal pad Thai.
Go on then. Go and order it, mate. Swaddy cab.
Swaddy cab.
Yeah.
Pad Thai chicken.
Pad Thai chicken. Yes. Number 30 with chicken and...
Okay, and I will have, please, looking at your beautiful board there, I will have Panangai.
Yeah, 51.
Kausaway.
Anyway,
yes, please, with make it pid, hot.
Make pid?
Yes, please. Yeah. Thank you.
Yes.
That's for me.
Yes.
Because they call me Mr. Hotman. I love lots of chilies and cafe lime leaves. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Now then, where do we sit? Because I see you've not got any tables.
In the middle there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what will you do? Call our order and we can come?
You have to come correct by your course.
Okay, we will do.
Yeah.
Have you heard me? Because we've had a couple of beers. Come here, David.
Jeffrey.
We are talking Tiglish like this, as though they don't understand. Sorry, love.
Okay,
can we order that then, please?
Yes, please.
And also, can I order, because I'm feeling very hungry,
yes.
Can I have the Thai fish cake?
Thai fish cake.
Five pieces, please.
It's what number four?
Number four.
Yes.
Thank you.
And anything else, sir?
That's it, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
There we go. Whoa, look at this, Dave. We've got the Thai fragrant rice. We've got the fish cakes with the Nam Jim guy. We've got your pad Thai, which looks fantastic. And we've also got my Penang guy. Wow. Right, we've got it all here. This is our Thai food. We're gonna click into it now and just eat this wonderful food. Wow.
What a fantastic ending to a great day. Thai Thai in the market of Chester, as good as any restaurant that had Thai, guaranteed.
Mm. 10 out of 10. Brilliant. Wow, that was fabulous, wasn't it? Thank you, Thai Thai, and all the ladies and gentlemen who cooked our food. Absolutely wonderful. What a great day, what a great video. Give us a thumbs up, give us a thumbs down, leave your comments below, and don't forget to subscribe. We love it when you do that, don't we? And hit the little bell. And the main thing is, keep smiling!